go down to the beach, oh, like, cool, to tell people to go.
We're at the NHPCA Doggy Paddle Plunge to benefit the New Hampshire Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals. And I'm with Michelle and Savannah. Could you guys talk about this event a little bit?
Yeah, so this event is in support of the New Hampshire SPCA Animal Shelter. I'm actually a regular volunteer there, so I decided to come to this event. Basically, people, they register online or they walk in and register and they donate whatever amount of money they're able to raise, and they plunge into the ocean in the middle of February, and it's to raise money for a good cause.
For me, I'm here because I'm allergic to animals, so I can't really help out as Michelle can. So I've learned to go out in other ways, and this is one way that I can help. And just like she said, this is an amazing way for you to get out there if you can't do everything that you want to.
In fact, all SPCAs all across the country do amazing things. I mean, you have all types of animals there, not just cats and dogs. So you guys are competing in pageants. You want to talk about that a little bit?
I'm actually not in official pageant uniform today, but I'm currently Miss Stratford County, and I will be competing for Miss New Hampshire, which is a preliminary to the Miss America Scholarship Program, so I'll be doing that in May.
I am competing as Miss Connecticut High School America 2014. I will be going to nationals in July in Orlando, Florida, competing along with my fellow contestants from New Hampshire, Mass, and all across the United States. So it's a great opportunity for me to be able to, as a high school student, participate in other curricular activities, and pageants give me a way into other things that I love to do.
Well, Savannah and Michelle, I have to commend you for, you know, volunteering at an event like this. This is like it's one of my, you know, biggest passions, animal, you know, protection.
Thank you for having us.
I'm with Courtney Brooks, Community Outreach Coordinator for the New Hampshire SPCA. This seems like it's going to be a great event.
Yeah, we're very excited for this event. This event is one of my favorites because it's a really creative and fun event, and it's for the gritty people who are really proud and dedicated to the animals, and they love what they do, and they want to show it, and are so enthusiastic. So the energy at this event is incredible, and it shows. It's already showing, and we just started.
I would think the water temperature must be 34 or something like that. I don't know.
You know, I've been asked about the water temperature previously, and quite honestly, I can speak as one of the plungers. I'm jumping in as well, and you really don't think about the water temperature. So it is cold, but in retrospect, you don't even feel it because you're there for the animals. And we don't have any wardrobe requirements either. You can wear a wetsuit if you want. You can wear a bikini. It's whatever you prefer.
How many years have you been doing this event?
This is our fourth year.
Does it get bigger every year, you think?
It has so far, yep. I think this year we have 48 plungers. The first year we had about 15.
I think a lot more people seem to be swimming in the winter, polar plunges type of thing.
Yeah, I think plunges themselves have become a lot more popular over the years. And it's a good event for us because it really, the people who actually do the plunge, you know, use it as a good way to show their true support. You know, they're taking this risk and they're doing this difficult thing to show how much the NHSPCA means to them. Our success rate is extremely high, and it's the nice part about it is, you know, although it can be sad to do all the incomings, the nice part about the job is definitely the outgoings and the amount of animals that we're able to place into nice homes.
I have nothing but praise for the SPCA.
Thank you.
Lindsay, you're going to take the plunge here?
I am. I'm taking the plunge for my store, Pet Life in Portsmouth.
You've swam in the winter before?
Not before, no.
What's the proper way to go into the water, do you know?
Run really fast.
Oh, do you dive in? Are you going to get fully immersed in there, you think?
Yep. You got to go all the way.
Like people said this is over like in 2 minutes. Like from start to finish, it's that quick, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah, it feels like a lot longer with the cold, though.
Thanks for talking with HC Media. Thanks.
Thank you.
I'm with Deborah Ford. You're going to take the plunge?
I am.
And you have the plunge sweatshirt on.
I do, actually. This is a plunge from the Special Olympics. So I do the Special Olympics, and this is the second time I'm doing the doggy paddle plunge for the New Hampshire SPCA.
What's it like diving into that water, would you say? Could you describe it?
It's cold, exhilarating, a little bit nuts, but fun, and it's for a great cause.
So basically, how long? You just basically jump in and jump out? Or?
Jump in, jump out. I try to get my head wet, and then I am out as fast as I possibly can. My firm is Jackson Lewis, a law firm in Portsmouth, New Hampshire, and we sponsor the doggy paddle for the New Hampshire SPCA, and we're pleased to do so.
Are you guys going to go swimming with these costumes on?
You bet we are.
Yeah, everything but the crown. We don't want to ruin that. We didn't win the costume contest last year, so this year's the year.
What's it like when you hit the water? Is it?
It is like a shock, and you are completely numb.
So it's kind of indescribable. It's hard to tell somebody who hasn't done it.
It is impossible to explain.
Yeah.
It's really fun, though. Everyone's just so jazzed up, and last year I was afraid I was going to hit my face because it was really shallow, but everyone else was diving in, so I felt like I had to. This year I'm going to go to a little deeper water.
So you'll stay in maybe more than 2 seconds?
No, 2 seconds.
Two seconds is enough.
Yes, you guys are active in the SPCA, New Hampshire SPCA?
I'm actually doing it for my grandfather who passed away, and he's active in dog rescues, and I've rescued 2 animals from the SPCA, so.
And I used to volunteer there with my client from Easter Seal, so I'm pretty familiar with some of the animals and people who work there.
I'm with Kathy Giordano and Lillian McCormick. Want to talk about this event a little bit?
And it's really a great cause to help all our animals in need. There's so many animals that need loving homes, and they get really good care here, so we hope to be able to keep it going.
And you guys aren't swimming, right?
I volunteered my husband. I can't even go in the ocean in the summertime. So.
Same here. The husbands are both going in. They're brave. Yeah,
Lil and I just started volunteering together.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. Well, what they call the dog walkers, but then we volunteered for something, registration here. So.
You have a lot of different pets other than dogs and cats at the SPCA.
You have a big pig. What do they call it?
The regular pig.
Pot belly pig.
Oh, awesome.
There was even ducks one day, little baby ducks. Yeah.
Obviously, you're going to be swimming today.
Yeah, that I am. Well, I don't know if you call it a swim, but going in the water.
You're going to go in with all your clothes on?
Oh, yes.
Okay. And sunglasses?
Sunglasses,
awesome. What are you staying for, like 2 seconds, 3 seconds? Or?
Yeah, I might swim around a little bit.
Wow. How many times have you done this?
That's my first time. My wife's done it a couple times. But
just don't think about it, I guess. That's the key.
Just go right in. Yeah. Just like when you go swimming in the summertime. Don't touch the water. Just go in.
I'm with Superman and Batman. You guys, superheroes, you shouldn't have any problem with this.
Absolutely. No, I got my Fortress of Solitude up in the north, so I'm used to the cold.
I mean, basically just kryptonite is your vulnerability.
Oh, exactly. As long as it's not floating around out there, I should be fine.
Yeah.
And the Batcave's cold and damp. It's fine by me.
Yeah. Where's Robin? He's not here?
Robin's not here.
Okay.
Yeah, chickened out. He's up in the nest.
You still working for the Daily Planet? Or?
Kind of passing the time that way, yeah.
Yeah. You got a beard now. I'm used to it with the glasses.
Well, I figure with the glasses, everybody saw the movie. They know that the glasses are the disguise, so I had to get the beard going just to fool some more people.
All right, this should just be a normal event for you guys. No big deal.
Yeah,
okay, cool. Laura, looks like you're ready to go, swim.
Yep.
Now, how long have you done this before?
Never done it before.
It should be a new experience.
It'll be an interesting one. My plan is just to run in and get out as fast as I possibly can.
Yeah, I think that's what everybody's plan is. This is for a great cause, New Hampshire SPCA, though. Are you involved with them at all?
I got my dog from the New Hampshire SPCA a couple years ago, and I chose to do it because of her.
You all suited up for the plunge here.
We are ready. Yeah,
you're going to go in just like this, right?
We are exactly.
You're
going
to wear your goggles too?
We're going to bring our goggles down. We just can't see with them very well to walk down to the water.
So you guys are all ready to dive in?
Absolutely.
Have you guys done this before at all?
First time.
No.
I noticed most people here, it's the first time swimming in the winter.
Yeah.
So it should be a totally new experience.
Absolutely, on our bucket list.
Do you have any fears of it, diving in?
No, my fear is when I get out, how cold I'm going to be.
All right, guys, you going to go in like this? Or?
We're going to go in like this. Those two together and me trying to keep up.
You guys are representing the Oyster River Middle School?
Oyster River, yep.
I'd like to thank Deb Ford, who is in the back with her dad. Deb is from Jackson Lewis, who is our presenting sponsor for this event. Without her help, we may not be here. So thank you, Deb. We really appreciate it. I want to thank you for the fundraising that you've done, for your participation here today, and for caring enough about the animals, because really that's what it's all about.
Matt, thank you so much for being here. I know Aaron and I are both so proud to stand alongside you and be plunging with you guys today. And without the people standing in this room, we couldn't continue to care for almost 2,500 animals every single year, give them shelter, food, and love until they find their forever home. What we also want to do is thank our in-kind sponsors. You guys have already experienced some of the delicious food that's being offered today. The Big Bean and Starbucks donated breakfast, and me and Ollie's, the Community Oven in Hampton, and Pizza Hut and the Flatbread Company are donating lunch. So you guys are in store for a delicious warm lunch after you get cold in the water.
Good man. Father-daughter, probably the only ones here.
What was it like going in? Can you describe it?
It wasn't as bad as I thought it would be.
No, definitely not as bad. The weather is gorgeous, so made it a lot easier when we came out.
Yeah.
First time you guys went swimming in the winter?
Yes.
In the winter, yeah.
Any advice you'd give to anybody doing this?
Just drink a lot of coffee, get warm before, and you'll be fine.
Don't think about it too much. Just go for it.
Do you think you guys will do more of this kind of thing?
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Probably swim every day.
Yeah. This is for a great cause, New Hampshire SPCA.
It's awesome.
Definitely.
We love the SPCA. The lonely
sea. David Blanding, Chief of Newcastle, right up on the Nile. Cold weather swimming, I mean, what are some of the biggest dangers of that? Would you say hypothermia?
That's a hypothermia, yeah. And, you know, when you first hit the cold water, you can have a shock, and it could cause a cardiac problem, and somebody's susceptible to that.
You're not supposed to dive in head first, is that?
Not a good idea, no.
You guys look like you're doing a good job. You had divers down here and everything.
Yeah, they call us 2 or 3 months in advance and, request us to come down.
They look like Navy SEALs in those suits. Thanks for being on HC Media. You guys didn't go swimming, did you?
She did.
Oh, okay. So, Sui, you went swimming.
I did.
Now, can you describe what it's like? Did you totally immerse yourself in it?
I did. I plunged in. Mm-hmm. It was very exciting. Mm-hmm. And when I leaped out, I felt so invigorated and so just like full of energy. And it did make me think about how when a dog goes in the water, they come out and they want to run circles. I kind of felt like that. I was kind of disappointed. We didn't have dogs running in the water with us. I've never done this before. So the anticipation, I didn't know what to expect. And I was really nervous. And then just leaping in the water, it was very freeing. And running out, I was ready to do it all over again.
Is this your first time?
This is my first time.
So, I mean, you had some trepidation before.
Yeah, I was a little nervous. It's definitely worth it. It was a blast.
It's like exhilarating.
It's very exhilarating, and since it's for a good cause, that helps too. But yeah, it was fun. I'm not frozen. Or insane.
Bob, did you immerse yourself totally in the water?
Yes, I did. I felt that if I didn't do that, it wouldn't count. So I ended up going all the way under. Wasn't bad, not as bad as I thought it was going to be. First time this year, and I plan on doing it for I don't know how many more years. I feel this thing's going to get bigger and bigger every year. I saw it on TV this morning, and I'm glad I did see it on one of the Channel 9. I just happened to see it on TV.
Some of the greatest things you ever do are just on the spur of the moment.
Spur of the moment. I'm like, up, jumped in the car, and here I am. So.
Guys, how was it diving into 36-degree water?
It was really cold.
Yeah.
Once you got in, you were numb, so it wasn't that cold when you got in, but out of the water, it was freezing.
Yeah. Did you dive in, or?
No, I didn't dive in.
Is that the coldest water you've ever been in? Yeah. Jeff, how was the experience?
Experience was great. This is my third time doing it.
Third time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Today I dressed up in a full green suit and jumped in.
I saw you.
Yeah. It's a great experience. I recommend it to everybody.
Did you dive in? You didn't dive in.
You did. Twice.
Twice?
Yeah.
What's it like when your head hits the water? Does it feel like a shock? Or?
Before this time, feels very good. Today was very scary because I had the mask over my face, so I thought I was going to die.
They had some police and fire divers out there to get, you know, ready for anything.
I almost feel bad that I disappoint them because they just sit out there, nothing exciting.
Are you a volunteer?
I'm actually an employee also as a volunteer.
So that winner is Batman, Michael McCormick. Woo! Oh, he's even got Batman's shirt.
I think you're the real Batman.
Oh, thank you.
There you go.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, and now we want to announce our top fundraisers. Again, we are so very grateful to everyone who participated in this event, but really our goal is to fundraise for the animals so we can keep doing what we're doing and be a protective agency for animals in need. So our third place fundraiser, who raised $1,240, our very own staff member, Jen Fry. Please join us. We're going to crown each of our top fundraisers. From the business that sponsored us, Jackson Lewis, Deb Ford.
Woo-hoo!
What's your total? Our top fundraiser this year, Jill Bevan, who raised
$1,820. But it's been no bed of roses.